Yo, what's the word? What's the vibes? We're just gonna be coloring for a little bit today, and then, you know, maybe, just maybe, I do a little something. Go hang out with some certified OG skaters at Transaction Skate Shop. You know, there might be a little meet and greet there. I don't know, you know, just throwing it out there. I might be doing that pretty soon, but yeah, right off rip, we're just gonna get right into coloring. So yeah, I don't know, this is I might not finish coloring, I might stream again later, but I do want to pull up to Transaction later for all my stylus folk out there. So we're just gonna get right into this. This is the wall color, something like that. Real simple stuff today, that's for sure. Wall color. All right, now let's get like a little bit of a brighter color for the ceiling here, something like this perhaps. Ceiling. Right now we're just choosing like rough colors that I think will kind of work. Right now these aren't perfect though. I'm gonna have to make this ceiling a little darker, I think. Maybe a little more saturated. Maybe I'll just do that right away. Maybe that actually should be darker like that. Doesn't look too bad actually. Alright, so we got those. We could do some floorboard details. I didn't really do that, but we'll for now just color it. And yeah, just for now let's do a color like this. We're gonna have to make it way darker, way less saturated. Something like that, at least for now. So let's color the table here. Thinking something like this off rip. Okay, so we'll use this color for now. So yeah, we're just gonna do the base of this table first. I'm gonna fix this line real quick as well. Share the same color for now as well. So just for now, I think I'm gonna give these bottles like a glass color. We're still gonna draw like some kind of like labels on them, some liquid inside of them and stuff like that, but I just didn't feel like doing it before. We'll get there eventually though, but for now we're just gonna do this. Okay, then we'll get sort of like a goldish color for this. And then pale beige color for the candle here. Need maybe a color like this for the wick, maybe darker than that though. Maybe lighter. Alright, so we need to do some corks for these bottles as well, which honestly will probably also kind of color in kind of under the bottle here. All those need to be way darker. Alright, so we're gonna bring these down all the way below the floor. And then I guess we'll just erase the edges off these lines. Okay, so then this second color, I'm gonna take this color and make it like a little more brighter. Solid. accidentally did that, but we're gonna... put that on somewhere. Let's see here. So I think we're gonna make like all these little bases. This iron color. Just a real dark metal. And that's just those two. So in the fang we can make like, at least for now, this color. Pretty good. I'm thinking this is kind of like a root color, like a the root of a tooth kind of a thing. So I'm gonna just make it like a little darker like that. Not bad. So in the hooks, I'm thinking I make like more of like a silver color. Looks pretty good. Do all these bases quick. never did one for this machete here, though, unfortunately, so I gotta do that. I think I'm just gonna get that over with quick. So we're gonna do that by making a base real quick. So I'm thinking something like this. Maybe not that big. Maybe we'll just probably pretty good. So since this is all one layer, I think I'm just going to do all that. I think I'm gonna grab the same color to be consistent. So that'll be the glass color. Bring that down to 20, you know the vibes. Cool. I think we could do probably this counter real quick. Maybe I'll grab this color. Alright, I'm gonna bring this platform, I guess you could say, way down. Because it needs to go underneath this table base and that chair there. Should be good now. Now we need to color it in. careful here. Just make sure I'm getting over that line. Okay. Color. So I'm thinking maybe just like a pretty much the same color but lighter, and then I just fill this part in. We're doing a speed run today, folks. So it looks pretty good. We might have to kind of move the platform around a little bit. I think it looks maybe a little weird. Maybe it's better like that compared to, yeah. I think it looks better. Just save that. Okay. Guess we'll do the stuff on the wall then we'll do the snake skin on the floor here. So let's go, baby. So the off-rip, I'm just going to make that a little brighter. So it's not the same color as that. Just a little something. We'll get sort of this kind of color for this part, maybe. Maybe make this more like gray. Make that slightly darker. I think that works pretty well. I wanna say that I feel like the machete could be angled a little down more. Looks a little better. Cool. Alright, we could do this big one here now. So I'm thinking maybe we make somewhat more of a paler, like stone kind of color for the metal here. It's really the same color. precise with what I'm doing here. So I'm going to change this color right away too, because I'm not really happy with this. I think it needs to be, yeah, something like that. I like how it's like real light, but it's also kind of, it's not just like a pure gray like these ones are. Yeah, and then we're gonna, I guess, make that even darker. Looks pretty good, and then I just am gonna take, maybe I'll do like a real deep brown kind of color instead of black for this one. I feel like that might look pretty good. Yeah, that looks good. It's a nice sword right there, yeah? Yeah, it's a nice fucking sword. Turn my space heater down a little bit. We're making some progress, ladies and gentle folks. Okay. First, let me fix this typo, because that's crazy. Alright, I'm just gonna hide the back edge of this, because I don't want to get confused, and I will. So we're just gonna do the front real quick. Let's go. All right, now we gotta do the back part. And just make sure. Okay, yeah, so the base is a different part. So now we're just gonna take that color, make it darker, a little more saturated. And honestly, I think we're just gonna hide the front for now so we can fully, okay, never mind. I didn't fully draw it, so we're just gonna fill in what we can see. And That's all we really need to do anyway, so fuck it. So some of the stuff on this back layer, though, is going to be sort of, I'm drawing all of this dark right now, but not all of it's going to be dark. We're going to have to make another layer with the same lighter color as the front layer, because, like, for instance, this isn't really behind the front of the skull or anything. There's nothing really in the way of it. So we'll do that in a second. Although we should probably do it. Alright, this is what we're gonna do. Do that. We'll just fix this. Just make it longer. And then we'll fix. Little that, little of that, yes sir, yes sir, yes sir, uh-huh. Alright, now we're gonna do the lighter color again on a few of these things, like for instance, this big meaty bone right here. This makes sense to be the lighter color because it's right in the open, not covered by anything. As well, these two, I'm just gonna say yeah because there's something even further behind them, and they're pretty much on the same level as the other ones we just colored in, so I think that's the best way to do that. So yeah, there's a snake skeleton right there. Now we just gotta color the base, which I think we're gonna just once again use this color right here. This little edge color here. Make this slightly lighter. Looking good, looking good. So yeah, we got the map, the snake, the rug, and then the main character, and then we're done with coloring. For the most part, because we still have to do like little labels and stuff on here and whatever, but that's not really at the time my main concern. So I'm thinking like a pretty desaturated brownish green for this snake here. Might even be too green. Looks like a pretty decent green. I do like that color. Okay, so let's do the little belly color here. Now this is gonna be colors similar to this, I'm thinking. Might even be more like desaturated and even brighter, maybe. A little closer to like a white kind of color. Although that's honestly not too bad. We'll mess with it a little bit, maybe. Maybe make it darker. Yeah, I think maybe something like that is pretty good. Let's just see. Yeah, I think I like this more. Cool. So we got the teeth, the mouth, the eyes. Let's just do a nice solid red real quick. So that's tongue. Gonna lower lightness on that a lot. Okay, then above that we're gonna have sort of a pinkish color for the inner jaw there. Just use this for now. Something like that, perhaps. Okay, we'll do the teeth color, which we're just gonna use this bone color here. And then I feel like the eye should be like sort of this color, but more yellowish. Sorry, my maybe I'll make the eyes red, I don't know. Doesn't look bad though. Just gonna turn this off. Stupid ass shit. Alright. Maybe I should make them more yellow. Like that, actually. Alright, now I think honestly, what's throwing me off is that the left side of his mouth has this kind of jaw thing, but his right side doesn't. So I think it's only right that I just go ahead and sort of block the other one. Kind of add that in. That obviously looks better. Okay, we got the snake done. The map's gonna be a little bit of a pain just because there's so much detail. Let's just do the rug real quick. Get that out the way. So I'm gonna start with this color, but I think I wanna make it more of like a brown color. So I think I'm gonna do something like this. So that's a pretty good color. I might have to make it a little darker, maybe. But for now, it's pretty solid. Still, like, very green instead of brown. That's pretty good. Okay, so now we're gonna do. I need to do that. Fuck. So we're gonna take this color and make it a lot brighter and less saturated. And this will be sort of like the edge color. Initially, I was thinking almost like a white color, but I don't think that would really look right. Before I forget about it. Somehow missed. Whoops. Some of that, I'm sure more will reveal itself in the future when I'm actually looking for it, but yeah. I'm just gonna roll with this. Thank you. like that. Looks pretty cool. Still gotta fix this line here. That looks pretty good. All right. So we should do the map and the dude. So luckily we kind of have a bunch of colors we can just kind of steal real quick. It's not gonna be one to one, but we can start off with these colors for sure. So I'm thinking we off rip kind of just color all this in. In fact, honestly, maybe it being color in general is kind of not the greatest idea. I don't think it's going to look too well, and also it's not going to make as much sense because it's not like, you know, they're printing maps in color back then, or at least if they are, it's going to be probably pretty light. I don't know why I said back then, like it's a time period. It's just that, LaRouche is like very there's different levels of technological advancedness across the lands of LaRouche. So it's like where Montezuma is, this character right here, there's not really it's not like super technologically advanced. He's in the middle of, like, you know, a dense wetlands, so. Anyway, that looks cool. I'm thinking maybe we take this. Grab this color. Maybe make it a little darker. Stuff that's in the map. Yeah, I put that all together. Can actually, I'm thinking take this color and then make it like really dark. So it's not black, but it's like that. I feel like that works a little better. Well, something like that. It looks kind of nice. Could be the move, potentially. And then, yeah, I don't know. I think that's probably pretty good. I think I'm going to find this reference right here so I can take this young man's colors. Nice and easy. So let's start with the thing furthest in the back here, his big old sheath here. The way. Second color, and honestly I think these colors are pretty good off rip. I don't think I have to mess with them too much personally. I think they're pretty solid. So let's see, this should be the same color as the sheet that we'll need. Yeah, so we're gonna do blackish color. Okay, and then that's for the hands, parts of the arm. I believe everything is good except for the swords and hands. Otherwise, there shouldn't be anything really overlapping. I guess the horns as well, but that's... a little different anyway, but... okay, cool. So, yeah, we're just gonna... do this all together. This is one big piece here, essentially. Hide that for now. So yeah, just this color here on the arms. Else we got probably this right here. Should be cool. And then yeah, just the hands, which we'll have to do separately anyway, so nice and easy. Get that out the way. Cool. All right. So now I guess we'll do this brown color, which is going to be his strap thing, and his boots, and his belt. In the words of Travis Scott, belt. Alright. Civil Dev Brown, I think it might be used for. Yeah, it's on his hat as well. So actually, I think I can do that right away. Just get it done. Cool. Okay. Get this out the way. Oh, and the brown is for these straps too. I forgot about that. We'll get that in a second. Come on, Photoshop. Come on, Photoshop. Oh, I think it froze. Hold up. I gotta reboot it. One second, y'all. Gotta love Photoshop, baby. I believe that here we'll take this color right here. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm also gonna make these straps on the boots the light brown color as well, because on the original picture they're kind of just black lines, I believe. Yeah, so slightly different, but you know, tis what it is. Okay, I think that's probably pretty good. So yeah, we're gonna do all these straps now in this regular brown. Ones too, swag. All right, what else we got? What else we got? Okay, we'll do dark green. And then this is gonna get a little fucky because there's this medium green right here and here, and then there's this light green. So we're just gonna do dark green, which is gonna be, ooh, this is a different green too, huh? We'll just do green. A lot of different greens, but this is basically like the robe and the hood, or whatever you'd like to call this, skirt. It's just those two, and then this other dark green is just for the armor here, 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 and here. So we'll do dark green. Thank you. Something like that. Just gonna do this, make it easy. We're gonna call a dark light green, I guess. And it's gonna be this color. So it's the knees, shoulders, the edges of the armor, and then the mouth part. So not this inner part here, but right here, and then this part as well. I should really add some straps right here. So I gotta kind of remind myself to do that later. This is the light green, this is not. Okay, then we're gonna name this one just light green. So then this is gonna be all these little inner details, and then this mouth part right there. And these straps. Although honestly, I think, or no, that's not even true. Okay, I think that's good, and then we have like a black color, which is gonna be this, and it goes on the face, the mouth, the neck, and the chest here. So that's pretty much this. Oh, forgot some light green right there too. Whoopsie. Thank you. That's what we're gonna do. First and foremost, this, this, this. Okay. Delete that. Then, right here, we forgot a little bit of this dark gray. We also have to add straps right here as well, which we'll do later. But I think it's only right that we at least write, like, draw straps here, like a. Something like that. And then I think it might make sense to just fill these in like that. Could change it to the original color, this weird color here, later if we feel like it, but I don't really see a point to. So I'm not really going to probably do that now. Also kind of follow that a little bit, see if that shows at all. But yeah, then we got this other green here, which I think is just for this chest color. So that's just gonna be all of this and all of this, and yeah, it's gonna go way down there like that. This edge we'll just fill with this green. And it looks like I've kind of fucked up a little here, so I gotta fix this. Let's just draw some straps there as well. Okay, we're making progress. We're getting there, that's for sure. So anyway, we got this hat color. Do that real quick. Okay, then we got this color for these little details here, and this is also a color for the sword, so we gotta keep that in mind. Okay, and then we're going to, whoops, got a post on Instagram, uh-oh. Together, but yeah, we're gonna just go in. So I forgot to border this layer off, so I'm gonna do that quick. As you can see, it fucked up a little bit. looks slightly better. I don't know why, it just does. Cool. So let's do the hands and stuff now. Yeah, we'll do the sword first, that would make sense. So we got this color for the handle. Take this color for now for this part here. I'm gonna at least alter it a little bit because I don't want although that is a pretty nice color, but I think maybe make it more like that, just so it's not the same color as that one, so it doesn't blend in. Sword is good. Now we're gonna do the hands. And the hands should just be two colors, so nice and easy. We'll just do the hand guards or whatever. Hand pads. And then we'll grab this color here. Beautiful, fucking beautiful, dude. And then just to make my life a little easier so I don't have to like erase and redraw stuff, I'm just gonna draw this like that on a separate layer. Real simple. Extra straps, and then color, and then we're just gonna grab this color right here. Fill these in. Okay, let's make some minor adjustments here, just trim that a little bit. Okay, now draw that. looking pretty damn good, boy. So anyway, we're gonna hide that. And yeah, we're pretty much done coloring. We still need to do a couple things that are like, you know, real small, but I'm gonna do something. I'm about to go somewhere, do something. So I'm just gonna add some small details. You know, maybe just kind of add some kind of ridges here, some floorboards here, maybe, you know, some details here, maybe a door here. Bottle there or something, maybe even a plant. I think that'd be really cool. Small tree or something. Chair here or something. So yeah, we'll do that in the future. For now, I'm done drawing and coloring and stuff. We could do like some, you know, patterns here on the floorboards. Stuff like that. Outside of that, I think we're chilling. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to save this as a copy. JPEG. Okay. And that's gonna be all for today, folks. Let me just unhide this to-do layer, label it, and then I'll just do all shadows and highlights. Gradients, and that should be it. So I'm just gonna do and gradients. Oh, and then you know, just draw the liquids in here and the labels and all that. Same thing here, draw the little cork, you know, the vibes, glow, and I think that should be straight. So yeah, in the future, we're going to do all of this and then shadows and highlights. I don't know if we're going to do it all in one stream, but that's what we have to do so far. So thank you to everyone who tuned in. I appreciate y'all. Y'all have a good one. Bye.